EA Sports. It's in the game.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a shit about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Poison the multitude, they be quick to accuse. When you got different views, just know you gon' pay the price. Best up an item you choose.
Money ties in the culture, hit you with them cat ultra. I knew you was a vulture, Holy Ghost get the ushers. No, I can't touch you. Shock you, then now you fluster. Crashing down, I was cluttered. Doing sort of, rolling on through the rubber. Remember this a jungle, the top I was gonna get something. The middle gotta stay hunting. Why the rush left for nothing? 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 Agitated illusion, only bit for confusion. The institution, modern day execution. Think I need the solution, maybe not should I do it. Just put it in the music, just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give it to all what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
I'm a win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, I'm turning knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Yeah, whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating round here. I'm the GOAT, little man, and I made it loud and clear. Put the gas on them like I whip the Cavalier. Show no love, got the confidence, no fear. I use a dub, I'ma win, I won't lose with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this. Ay, yeah, I'ma act a fool with this.
Welcome back to MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. The Giants possessing the football. We rejoin the action. Keep it with Barkley on first down. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here.
Barkley again, the ball carrier.
In on the stop there, Andrew Sendejo. The last run got three. Now here's second and seven.
Second and seven at the 44-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Jones. That's complete to Slayton. The Giants on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This is third and four.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
That's another New York Giants.
50 catches for him now on the year, and he's got a first down.
6 yard line.
The draw. This is Barkley. Two yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Sheldon Richardson on the stop.
From the gun, Jones gets this out to Saquon Barkley.
Jones pass.
No gain on that one, and it's going to bring up a third down.
He steps out of bounds right at the line of scrimmage.
Operating from the gun, Jones. Catch made by Slayton. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
First and 10 at the 30.
That's a play that will likely be forgotten when you talk about big moments in this game. But plays like this are critical to keep drives going. And if points result, we'll call this play significant.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They go back to the ground now with Barkley. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, the last drive, they went three and out.
The 22-yard line.
It's Barkley, and he's taken down after a gain of three as they move it from the 22 to the 19.
Taken down at the 19-yard line.
We've hit the two-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7.
And seven.
And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And he'll get this underneath, dropping it off for Barkley. And he'll get it here to the 10-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
But they certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
To the end zone, but it's incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10.
It leads to second and 10.
To throw again, Jones. This will be caught at about the 5. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. Jones now from the gun on 3rd down.
Jones.
And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down. Rosas' kick is good. And they will move up by 10 now, 17-7.
17. Brown 7.
A good drive gets him inside the 5, but they could not punch it in.
And credit the defense, too. Make sure that that happens, because that was the old bend but don't break approach. Made sure they contained them when they absolutely had to and forced the field goal attempt that went through.
Donovan Peoples-Jones on the return. The Browns take over 1st and 10.
And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball, and then all of a sudden it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a 4th down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went 4 and out, so I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
Now the Browns signal for the 2nd of their timeouts, as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Open man is Higgins.
The pass.
And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught.
The pass. Complete to Rashard Higgins. It's a gain of
17. But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field, and here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They'll look to throw here on 1st down. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 46. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. And finding the tight end, Hooper.
The pass.
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game as we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, time for a sprint to the finish as it's time to get you caught up with what's happening around the NFL here in a pivotal Week 15. We'll begin up at M&T Bank Stadium in Baltimore. And it's the Ravens who have the lead in that one. Lamar Jackson with 3 touchdown passes. From there, let's get over to the Rockies and check out the Broncos at home in Denver. And you can see they trail the visiting Buffalo Bills in that ball game. Josh Allen with 3 touchdown passes. Lastly, let's check on one final game for you. And they trail in that ball game to the visiting Seattle Seahawks. 2 touchdown passes there for Russell Wilson. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
And he'll be stopped up at the 25.
First and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They find themselves down 17-7 as they start this drive, first and 10. The third quarter starts with a run by Chubb. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Solid way to start the drive. 13 yards, picking up the first. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. Chubb with a carry on first down. It's not going to yield much, maybe a yard. It's second down. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Brings up second.
They'll set up to throw. Got an open man. That's David Njoku, the tight end. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants 39.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius, understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball, and puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
So the drive takes him into Giants territory now, first and 10 at the 39-yard line. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. 4 plays, 3 first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. First down, they go right back to Hunt. The tackle made there by Kyler Fackrell. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8.
A gain of 2.
A run for Nick Chubb. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
The tackle by Leonard Williams. A 5-yard pickup on the play. And it's third down.
They run it again with Chubb. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short.
This team doesn't mind running the ball in any situation, and I thought he was going to get the first down the way the play developed, but the defense closed in and stopped him just about a yard short.
Yeah. Still just the third quarter, but they've got to make something happen. I think they know that. They're going for it on fourth. Now, meanwhile, they go for it on fourth down, and my goodness, incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it, and the Giants are going to get the football back. And he'll have a tough time living that one down. It's one thing, Charles, to drop a pass. It's quite another to drop it on fourth down.
And so many teams work on that in terms of locking in on those key downs. You know, I've seen, you know, you and I have both been to practices where we've seen, hey, third down situation, big third down alert, lock in here. Fourth down play, make sure you're focused.
And now look at this, big gain, but a fumble. And this is picked up by the Browns. And the return will stop right around the 25. These defenses have become so opportunistic, and no matter what you're playing, in this case wide receiver, you got to be careful.
I certainly do, because there is a phrase in today's football that we use all the time, completing the process of the catch. Well, it's after you do that where the trouble begins, right? Meaning you've tucked it away, you're trying to get downfield, but someone's always coming up trying to rake at the ball and knock it free.
On first down, they'll run with Hunt. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of five or six. The first down run got five. Here's second and five.
Brings up second and five. At the Giants.
Back to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10.
The pass.
Yeah, the Browns are going to have a first and goal as he's taken down at about the 8-yard line.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. 3 yards the game there, second down.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
And the ball smack dab on the 5-yard line. Here's second and goal. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. Call it a gain of a yard as they get a little bit closer here. It's third and goal. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Credit the Giants defense that time in pass coverage. Fourth down.
You get the sense that they're saying, we're not playing up to what we're capable of, and we're deep enough into the game that the early jitters are long gone, that they should now have some sense of continuity and be able to make some of these plays that they have not been doing so far.
So put 3 on the board, but you know, from that far into enemy territory, probably hoping for more.
Yeah, I think they're going to get together on the sideline and talk about it, right? Because you get that far, that deep, you want to come away with a touchdown. They'll take the 3, but they're going to file it away for the future.
New York ready to go again offensively. And last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You've got to protect the football.
So in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. And he gets this one just shy of the 40, down at the 39. First play of the drive going for 14 and a first down.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
Now Jones on first and 10. This one is Slayton over the middle. A gain of 6 there on first. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and 4.
Second and 4 at the 45.
From the gun, Jones. Now Jones is hit. He lost the football. And this is picked up by the Browns. The big man, get the oxygen tank ready. And he's into the end zone. It's a fumble return for a Browns TD. So they were down by a touchdown, probably just hoping the defense could hold them, maybe force the punt. Instead, they force the turnover and take it into the house.
Well, the plan was perfect. That's exactly what they wanted. Instead, they got a lot more than that. Big-time capitalization by taking the ball away and putting it in the end zone.
Here's Seibert now to add the extra point. And he gets it to go, and we're all even, 17 apiece. The scoop and score, always an exciting play in football, and we witnessed it there, grabbing it off the ground and then rumbling it into the end zone for six. 17-17 the score, all even to this point as the kick's away. Taken about 7 yards deep, and Ballantyne going to sit on this one. That'll be a touchback.
25-yard line.
The New York set to take the field. Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10 at their 25-yard line. And he'll drop here to throw. They'll complete this to Ingram, his tight end. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31.
Brings up second and four at the 31-yard line.
To throw again on second down. Jones finds his tight end Ingram.
That's good for a Giant.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before you get a good head of steam going.
And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just help receivers find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air, nice chunk of yardage there, and then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
Jones throwing on first down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll go down at the 26, following a gain of six. A gain of six there on first.
Brings up second and four.
Looking to throw again on second down. Jones out to the right here to Shepard. And he'll get it down this time to the 17.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
A first down carry for Barkley. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
A rare misstep on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's second and 12. Again, it's Barkley. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Maybe a gain of a yard that time, but yeah, from the spot, actually no gain. So third and long.
No gain on the play.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Operating from the gun, Jones. The Browns D locked in on third down, brings up fourth.
But you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those, but the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
On for the field goal, a 37-yard attempt.
Rosa's kick is good. And the Giants are off now to a 3-0 lead.
For Giants 20, Browns 17.
So the scoring drive encompasses 9 plays, and the net result, 3 points.
Take your disappointment and put it aside. 9 plays, yeah, they want to end up in the end zone with a touchdown. I get that. But sometimes those 9-play drives pay dividends later with another 9-play drive that culminates in a touchdown when they wear down the defense.
Ready to take over again on offense. Out comes Cleveland. Their drive last time, it stalled out. They were forced to take the short field goal.
And the key phrase, you nailed it. Forced to, because you know coaches look at these short field goals as a last resort, right? To them, That's not how drives are supposed to end. You're supposed to put six on the board. That's a consolation prize, like going to the county fair. You don't get the big stuffed animal on that one, do you?
No, you don't go top shelf. That's bottom shelf material. 3 yards the game there, second down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Second and seven, operating from the 34. Here's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. A gain of three last play. This time they double it and pick up six.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball.
And the giant rush gets home as down he goes. Marcus Golden make that now 8 sacks for him on the season.
Brandon, I think you understand the type of afternoon this offensive line is having. It is a long one for them. Long for you to spend it with me. Long for them trying to block those guys. They've given up a whole lot of sacks, and the speed and quickness that defensive line is eating them alive.
Here's Jamie Gillen now as he's on to punt for Cleveland. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. That's a 48-yard punt with the coverage holding him to three on the return. And it'll be Giant football, first and 10. Back on offense, New York gets set to take over. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking, because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly. Put it all the way down and try and increase your lead in a big way. And the best way to do it? Touchdowns.
And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Only gets 3 yards there on the heels of the 1 yard pickup. Sets up third and six.
Brings up third and six.
From the gun, Jones. Jones in trouble here, and down he goes. Larry Ogunjobi in there to drop him for his 11th sack of the year.
So if we recount real quick, he had the touchdown earlier, and now he comes up with the sack here. No doubt about it, he's having himself a game.
Here's Riley Dixon now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Fair catch taken just inside the 40-yard line. A 40-yard punt, no return, and the Browns will take over, first and 10. Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
They've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so well. Go to someone else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Now Chubb. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. 38-yard line, second and 9. We're off to the fourth quarter here in week 15. Happy holidays to all. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Still 9 remaining on second down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. This pass complete to Higgins. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Giants' 24-yard line. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. Tell you what, he's been able to put the ball in some tight spots all game long. That throw, no different.
Yeah, a lot of people would call it a gutsy type of a throw. I think he looks at it as, I can do it, so it's not that big of a deal to me, and I'm going to keep firing.
Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it.
He'll get this one underneath to Hunt,
and he'll get it down this time to the 17. Give him 7 on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
Brings up second and
on the carry, it's Chubb. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. Now we've got a Giant player here, slow to get up after that last play. We'll get an update when we return to MetLife Stadium. Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. They'll look to throw now on first down. And he completes it to Hunt.
And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
That catch good for only a couple.
It's second and 8 at the 11-yard line.
This will be caught just inside the 10. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds, right around the 7. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. The gun. They'll look to throw, and he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Rashard Higgins with touchdown number 7 on the year, and the Browns have taken the lead. Those are the types of plays in these moments they were hoping for from this young rookie, able to put him up here in the fourth quarter.
How about the kid? You just mentioned it, the fourth quarter. This is when you have to make those winning plays. That's what he just did. Doesn't ensure anything, but he certainly gave his team a heck of a chance, didn't he?
Seibert on for the PAT. And that will make this a 4-point game. So that drive goes 8 plays, and it's capped off by the Browns' touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. On the return, Corey Ballantyne. And out a little across the 25 to the 27.
On the return, the Giants take over first and 10.
As the Giants head back out there, let's take a look at the playoff picture in the NFC.
And as we take a look at the playoff picture, certainly still a lot of jostling to go in these final few weeks. For the moment, they would be a wild card team, far from locked up, but that's why this is exciting. These last few weeks, a lot to play for.
So much to play for. And remember, 7 teams in each conference go to the playoffs instead of 6. And not to mention, remember when the league made that move a few seasons ago to put divisional games at the end of the year? So you get to week 16 and 17, you're playing for playoff spots and you're playing divisional games. Couldn't be more exciting than that.
Now this pass into the hands of Saquon Barkley, and he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. They'll contain him to just 4. Second down.
Second and 6.
Operating from the gun, Jones. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line.
Intercepted by the Browns. They'll take
CD, I know it's just his second year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape, he's like, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, second year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
First down, they'll run with Chubb. And they went the wrong way there. Losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively, because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They'll set up a throw. He's got Hooper on the short connection.
The pass.
6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
The Browns on third down. Just a 20% success rate at 2 of 10. This will be third and 6. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. It's a gain of 19 down to the 19, and it's a first down.
Couldn't just sit on it here, could they? Had to throw the ball on third down. Got the big completion in the pickup. Fresh set of downs now. They've got to feel great.
And defensively, a backbreaker.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. They'll look to throw. He's got Higgins over the middle. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
Brings up second and 5 at the 13-yard line.
That is caught at the 7-yard line.
Yeah, the Browns are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
At the 6-yard
line. So first and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They'll run with Chubb, and he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Nick Chubb with a lucky number 13 touchdowns now on the year. And the Browns add 6 to their lead.
A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there, and each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
And that one pushes the lead up to 11. That time, a 6-play drive. And Nick Chubb, the one to finish it off, as he does so with a touchdown run. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. Ballantyne to return. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
The Giants take over first and 10. At their own 20.
New York ready to go again offensively.
And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a 2-score deficit.
Jones and the Giants now with a first and 10, just shy of the 30.
And right away, he'll look to throw.
And he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. Larry Ogunjobi racking up sack number 12 for him on the year.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and it can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
Throwing on second and long. Jones, he'll get this out to Barkley, complete.
Jones pass.
Give him 9 on the play, and it'll be third down.
A gain of 9 brings up third and 8.
From the gun, Jones. And Tate's got it. And he's brought down, but not before picking up the first with a very effective stiff arm.
First down.
9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive.
This possession means so much for them. They've got to focus on this drive and find a way to make this a one-possession game. Yes. Got to get a score.
Yeah, so good with a field goal. Don't necessarily need a touchdown.
Jones on first down.
Jones in trouble here, and down he goes. Sheldon Richardson racking up sack number 12 for him on the year. He was trying to keep his eyes downfield. Nobody came open.
He's trying to do everything that he had been taught, right? Every bit of the technique. But if no one's open, there is no technique except make sure you hold on to the ball as you go to the ground when you're getting sacked.
Now then, after the sack, it'll be interesting to see what they have planned for second and 23. Another try after the first down sack. Jones, throw left side, complete to Ingram. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a third down. Operating from the gun, Jones. That's complete. He's got Barkley out of the backfield. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough, and they allow him to convert a third and 18. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified. Big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 45-yard line. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
It's now second and 10.
Jones now throwing again. They'll set up the screen to Barkley. Yeah, he will go out right near the 35-yard line. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
That's another New York Giants.
From the gun, Jones. It's brought in left side by Tate. And they're able to get this one past the 30 to the 25-yard line. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down.
First and 10 at the 25-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Jones. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line.
It's a gain of 8. Brings up second and 2 at the 16.
On second down, here's Barkley. And he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
First and 10 at the 12-yard line.
Now Saquon Barkley. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2.
8 yards on the pickup. Brings up second and 2.
From the gun, Jones. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Brings up third down and 2.
Now Jones on third and 2. And the ball is out. Jones got hit and lost it. And this is picked up by the Browns. He's at the 50. And he will take it across midfield and down to the 45.
I'll give some credit to the defense. They forced the big play, knocked the ball free from him, but it's a cardinal sin by the quarterback. Know where you are on the field. And he just gave up at a minimum 3 points.
And instead of getting down, takes the contact. The turnover ensues. The Browns set and ready to go on offense. They sit in a good spot, having the ball back after the fumble recovery and up 2 scores in the fourth quarter. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground.
Nick Chubb.
And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. Second down.
Brings up second and 10 at the 44-yard line.
This is Hunt on the draw play. 2 runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Taken down at the 43-yard line.
2 minutes left to play in this football game here on EA Sports.
Third down.
So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a third down now as they look for one more first down to help salt this one away. And he's got his man. That's Landry. And he is going to have a Browns first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. They run with Hunt.
And now with 1:52 to go, we get another pause of the action. A timeout here defensively. So second and 9, and you'd have to figure just about all 11 probably crashing the line here. Back to the ground. This time it's Chubb down right around the 25. The Giants going to burn their third and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. And I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the first down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the second half.
Austin Seibert on for the field goal. A 36-yard attempt.
Seibert's kick is good.
The kick is
good. And that will get the lead up to 14.
Browns 34, Giants 20.
So they settle for just the 3, but clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the 4th.
Without a doubt, obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off, but it's still 8 up time, got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
Evan Engram works his way back onto the field with the rest of this offense. All right, Charles Davis, what do we make of these numbers and what's happened to the big tight end here?
Well, I think a lot of times we talk so much about adjustments and what you're going to do at halftime that maybe we miss what actually goes on, because the sense is that, oh, they go into the half, they just change everything. That's not really true. A Super Bowl winning quarterback out of New York always used to say, you've worked all week on a game plan. There's a reason you have it. Just either play it better or make subtle tweaks to it. Otherwise, there's no sense even going into a ball game. A lot of times that's what they do. Just find a little subtle thing, one little change, and maybe it can make things a little bit better.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Mac Wilson, and he'll get this back to the 32-yard line.
They'll take over.
Boy, so another interception, CD, and it feels like he's starting to unravel a little bit.
And as you would expect, still a work in progress here in his second season. He has to start ironing out some of these mistakes, though, because now his head coach, his offensive coaches, they have to evaluate whether you keep playing him and let him work through it, or you start thinking about going to his backup.
And the Browns getting set to go. And they've got this one in hand. No timeouts remaining defensively, so this one should just be one kneel and then handshakes. The Browns in victory formation now as they take the knee.
Today's final score.
So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So for the Browns, they continue to make their case as a Super Bowl favorite as they move to 13-1. And they'll get another road date next week as their opponents will be the New York Jets. Meanwhile, for the Giants, they fall to 8-6 with the loss. And they'll be on the road next week for a matchup with the Baltimore Ravens. So for our entire crew, alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. Thanks for watching, everybody. We'll see you next time.
We'll be right back.